गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ पाइप्स एंड सिस्टम्स। दिस सेशन इज एन एक्सटेंशन टू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ टाइम एंड वर्क, राइट? तो आई एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम यू बिफोर वॉचिंग दिस सेशन, प्लीज वॉच माई सेशन ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ टाइम एंड वर्क, बिकॉज वी हैव टू इंटरलेट द डिफरेंट वराइटीज ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट वी हैव स्टडीड इन द टॉपिक ऑफ टाइम एंड वर्क विद द टॉपिक ऑफ पाइप्स एंड सिस्टम्स, राइट? Let's start with solving the question as well as understanding the different varieties and types, right? When we talk about the pipes and taps, so we have primarily two type of pipes. The first one, those who fill a tank, right? And second one, those who empty it, right? So let us start with the first statement here. Suppose it is given that there are three taps A, B and C. A can fill the tank in 10 hours, B can fill the tank in 15 hours, and C tap is emptying. C tap is going to empty. It can empty and fill tank in 20 hours, right? That's given to us. Now the first question is, if all three taps are open together, right? After how much time tank will be filled? Right. Now for answering this type of question, that is somewhere the same thing. The three persons are going to do a work, right? And it is given about ABC can do the work in that much of time. You have to find out after how much time work will be completed. Okay. Now, but here one thing you have to take care of that, because that is emptying, right? So we have understood two approaches in time and work. First one is, let us say total capacity of the tank is equal to one, right? It means first step A, its 1 hour work is 1 by 10. Second B, in 1 hour it fills 1 by 15. And C empties 1 by 20. That you can say. Okay. Now the next point is, if they are filling together, so just take it as 1 by 10 plus 1 by 15 minus 1 by 20. Right. Here LCM is said to be 60. So 6 plus 4 minus 3. Right. 6 plus 4, 10 minus 3, that is 7. You may say that they fill 7 by 60 part of the tank in 1 hour. The total tank will be filled in 60 by 7 hours. That becomes your answer. That's my question. Right. How we have done? We have assumed that total capacity to be 1. So A is 1 by 10, B is 1 by 15, C minus 1 by 20. They are working together. Take the LCM, solve it. That is 60 by 7. Right. The second approach is, instead of taking total to be 1, we may take total to be LCM of 10, 15 and 20, right? When we take LCM of 10, 15 and 20, we know that LCM is said to be 60. So I can assume that total capacity of the tank is equal to 60, right? Now A tap, in 1 hour it fills 6, because if 10 hour it fills 60 a liter, in 1 hour it can fill 6. Second B can fill 4 and C can fill 3, okay? Now 6 plus 4, 10 plus 3, 13. So we can say that they can fill 13 liter in 1 hour, right? Sorry, that is emptying. So we have to subtract it. 10 minus 3, that is said to be 7. So we can say that they can fill 7 liter in 1 hour, 1 liter in 1 by 7, and total they have to fill 60. So answer is said to be 60 by 7. That becomes your answer, right? So that's the basic approach that we understood in time and work. Same we apply here. But only the changing thing is that here there may be some taps that are going to fill and few taps that are going to empty. The tap that is going to empty, in that case we have to apply negative sign. Okay. Let's have next type of questions here. Suppose this information is same, right? ABC, the three taps are there. A can fill the tank in 10 hours. B can fill the tank in 15 hours. And C can fill the tank in 20. C can empty the tank in 20 hours, right? Now the question is, they are opened together. Tap B was closed after 3 hours, right? And tap C was closed after 2 hours of B. Right, the question is, what is the total time in which tank was filled? Okay, they are started together. B was closed after 3 hours, right? And C was closed after 2 hours of B. Question is, what is the total time taken by them to fill the tank, right? A is 1 hour work, 1/10. B is 1 hour work, 1/15, right? And C is 1 hour work, -1/20. That we can say. Now think of the question. A was filling from starting to end. Let us assume that total time taken by them is equal to X hours. It means that how much portion A has filled? X/10. B was closed after 3 hours. It means how much portion B has filled? 3/15, right? And C was closed after 2 more hours. 3 + 2, that is 5. It means how much C has worked? 5/20. And total tank is equal to 1. Because when the tank was filled, so we can say total is equal to 1. So after solving this, I have to find the value of X, right? What we can say? X/10 plus 1/5 minus 1/4 equal to 1, right? So you may say that X/10 equal to 1 minus 1/5 plus 1/4. LCM is equal to 20, right? So I may say that this is 20 minus 4 plus 5, right? So 25 minus 4, 21/20. You have to find X, right? 0 is cancelled out. You may say that X equal to 21/2, or you may say 10.5 hours. That becomes your answer, right? So here I can say that if they work together, if that case is there, in that case, total time taken by them to fill that tank, that's equal to 10.5 hours, that becomes my answer, right? The questions are simple. Only whatever concept you have studied in the time and work, that thing you have to apply. With that, you are in a position to get your answers. Let's have the next variety of question here. It's given that there are 3 taps A, B and C, right? A tap can fill the tank in 4 hours, B tap can fill the tank in 5 hours, and C tap can empty the tank in 6 hours. That information is given, right? It's given that it can empty the tank in 6 hours, right? It's given that tap A was opened at 6 o'clock, right? At 7 o'clock tap B was opened, at 8 o'clock tap C was opened. Question is, at what time tank will be filled? At what time tank will be filled? We have to find the exact timing when the tank would totally be filled, right? Now what we can say, let us say that total capacity of the tank is 1. So A is 1 hour work is 1/4, B is 1 hour work is 1/5, C is 1 hour work is -1/6. Okay, let us say that the total time taken by them to fill the tank is X hours. It means how much part A has filled? X/4, right? Now B is opened at 7 o'clock. It means it was opened 1 hour later, right? If A has worked for X hours, it means B has worked for X minus 1 hours. So you must take it as X-1, right? And C has opened at 8 o'clock. It means it has worked for X-2, right? And total tank was filled. So you may say that total capacity is 1. Now, after solving this, we have to find the value of X. So LCM of 4, 5 and 6, right? So what we can say that LCM of 4, 5 and 6, that is equal to 60. LCM, take the LCM to be 60, right? 4 will go on 15. 15X plus 12, you may say that 12x minus 12, right? 6, 10, so minus 10x, right? Plus 20, equal to 1, that you can say, right? 15 plus 12, 27 minus 10, 17x, right? Here I can say 20 minus 12, 8, plus 8 equal to 60. You may say that 17x equal to 52, x equal to 52 upon 17, which is approximately equal to 3/17 hours, right? Means 3 hours are complete and 1/17 hours, right? You may just convert that 1/17 hour into minutes. So I can say 1/17 into 60, that is approximately equal to 3 minutes. So what we can say, total time they have taken 3 hours and 3 minutes, right? So we can say that the tank was filled approximately at 9:03. That becomes your answer, right? So here what we can say, First of all, you take the total time taken by them to fill the tank is X hours, right? On that basis, A has filled X by 4 part, B had filled X minus 1 by 5, and C has emptied X minus 2 by 6, right? And total work done by them is equal to 1. After solving this, I can find the value of X, right? On that basis, my answer is said to be 52 by 17, or we can say 31 by 17, and our answer would be there. 93 becomes our answer. Okay, let's have the next variety of question here. It's given that tap A can fill the tank in 10 hours, right? Tap B can fill the tank in 15 hours. Okay, and there is tap C. Tap A can fill the tank in 10 hours. Tap B can fill the tank in 15 hours. There is tap C, which can empty the tank. Which can empty the tank, right? So that information is provided to us. Okay. So what the question is, if they work together, if they work together, tank was filled in 8 hours, right? And emptying tap, that is C, it empties 15 liter water per minute. We have to find out what is the capacity of the tank. Question is, what is the capacity of the tank? Right. Now, if I have to answer it, because I have to find the capacity of the tank, right? And about the capacity, only C tap is given, that empties 15 liter water per minute, right? If in this question I am able to find out how much time is taken by C tap to empty it, with that I can answer my question, right? Now, question becomes, how much time is taken by the C tap to empty the tank? Okay. Now, for answering this, what I can say, one approach is very simple. Let us say total capacity is 1. A fills in 1 hour 1 by 10, B fills 1 by 15, right? And C empties it. So I may say minus 1 upon C, and total time is 1 upon 8. That you can say, right? 1 by 10 plus 1 by 15 minus 1 by C equal to 1 upon 8, right? From where I can find the value of C. Just take there, you may say that 1 by 10 plus 1 by 15 minus 1 by 8 equal to 1 by C, right? Here I can say that LCM is equal to 10, 15 and 8, right? You may say that LCM is 120, then it should be 12, right? Plus 8 minus 8, 15, okay? That is 1 by C, right? 12, 8, 20 minus 5, 5. So I can say that C would be 24, okay? It means C takes 24 hours to empty the whole tank, right? And in 1 minute it empties 15. It means in 1 minute it empties 15. In 1 hour it empties 15 into 60. That is equal to 900, right? Here I have to find the total capacity. So I can say that total capacity is equal to 900 into 24. Just multiply. So that would give you as 00, right? 94, 36, 6, 216, right? So we can say that total capacity of the tank would be 21,600 liter. That becomes my answer, right? Means the questions are very simple. Any approach you may apply, but in answer we have to just find out what is the time taken by C to empty it, right? Once you have that, you can easily answer it, right? The second approach that you can say, just take the LCM of 10, 15 and 8. You may say that LCM is 120, right? It means A in 1 hour fills 12, B in 1 hour fills 8. Right, they work together and in 8 hours they fill it. It means we can say that A, B, C, they fill 15, right? Obviously, C will empty it. How much? 12 plus 8, 20 minus 15, that is 5. So we can say that C empties 5 liter per minute. Total capacity is 120. It means how much time is taken by C? 24 hours, right? So this you may get by this way also. Once you get this 24 hours, then it is very easy for answering your question. You can say that time taken by them is equal to 24. That becomes your answer. Okay. Then we have the next variety of question, that is alternative doing of work, right? The same we have done in the concept of time and work. Similar type of question you may have here, in which the tabs are working alternatively, right? Suppose there are three tabs A, B and C. A can fill the tank in 10 hours, B can fill the tank in 12 hours, and C can empty it in 20 hours. Right. Question is, if all three are opened alternatively, in pattern of A, B and C, right? Then what is the total time taken by them to fill the tank? Right. Question is, A can fill the tank in 10 hours, B can fill the tank in 12 hours, and C can empty it in 20 hours. If all three are open together alternatively, so what is the pattern of every sim is first A is opened, then B is opened, then C is opened. So what is the total time taken by them to fill the tank, right? So what we can say in the alternative type question, earlier I also told you that in the topic of time and work, we have to take the LCM of 10, 12 and 20, right? We know that LCM of 10, 12 and 20 is 60 liter. That you can say. Now in 1 hour, A fills 6, B fills 5, C empties 3. That you can say, right? 6, 5, 11 and 3, 8. It means I can say effectively, in 3 hours, 8 liter of the water can be filled in the tank, right? But my target is 60. What's my target? 60. Now we have two varieties of question here. In the first variety, either 60 is a multiple of 8, it's not an exact multiple of 8, then we take close multiple which is smaller than 60, right? So you can say 8 7s are 56, it means in 21 hours 56 liter have been filled, right? Now in 22nd hour, whose turn is there? There's a turn of A, right? And we know that A in 1 hour filled 6, it means A can fill it, right? What we can say? 6 liter is filled by A in 1 hour, A has to fill 4 liter, it means time taken by A is 4 by 6 hour, or you may say 2 by 3 hours, right? So finally you can say your answer is said to be 21 by 2 by 3 hours. That becomes your answer, right? That becomes my answer. So what we have done here, a very simple question. A takes first, when we talk about A, B and C, 6, 5 and then that is 3, right? Add both 11 minus 3, 8. So we can say effectively in 3 hours, how much is filled? 8, right? Now, I have to take a close multiple of 8, that is close to 60. You can say 8 7s are 60, that is 56. So I can say that in 21 hours, they have filled 56 a liter, right? Then there's a turn of A, right? I know that A can fill 6 liter in 1 hour, it means it has to fill only 4, right? So just solve it. 21 by 2 by 3 hours, that becomes your answer. It's same as to the concept that we have studied in the topic of time and work. Let's have the next variety of question here. Now this is a very important type of statement, right, in which, suppose let us have a question, ratio of diameters of 3 taps is given, 1:2:3. Ratio of diameters of 3 taps is given, 1:2:3, right? It's given that if tap with highest diameter, tap with maximum diameter fills the tank in 10 hours, right? Then what is the time taken by the tap with minimum diameter to fill the tank? Right, that's a question, right? Or the question may be, what is the time taken if all three are open together? Right, question may be any of the type. Let us try to understand, whenever the ratio of the radius or diameter is given, right, in that case one thing is clear that we know that time taken is inversely proportional. Here the condition is time taken is inversely proportional to area of cross section. That thing we have to consider. Right? Means if ratio of the diameters is given, suppose 1:2:3, we can say that time taken is inversely proportional to the area of the cross section, right? Here area of the radius is 1:2:3, right? The area of the cross section is 1:4:9. Area of the cross section is 1:4:9, right? Now we know that area time taken is inversely proportional, right? It means that time taken would be, what I can say, that is 1:4:9. Now the first question, let us take the first question is, time taken by tap with maximum diameter is 10 hours. It means, whose diameter is 9? It takes 10 hours. Diameter is 9, it takes 10 hours, right? And I know that both are inversely proportional, right? So we have to find the time taken tap with minimum diameter. If 9, whose diameter is 9? So both area of cross section is 9, it takes 10 hours. If area of cross section is 1, in that case it takes 90 hours. Right? Hence answer to my first question is equal to 90 hours. That becomes my answer. Okay. Similarly, second one, if all three are open together, it means total cross section area is 9, 4, 13 and 1, 14. Total cross section area is 14. So what you can say? When cross section area is 9, right, so they take 10 hours. When cross section area is 1, they take 90 hours, right? And when cross section area is 9, 4, 13, 1, 14, so what is the time taken by them? 90 upon 14, right? You may say 45/7 hours. That becomes your answer, right? So in any question where ratio of the radius or diameter is given, so first of all, what do you do? You first take the ratio of the area of the cross section, right? And then you may compare and you may answer your question. One thing is clear to that, the maximum cross section area, their time taken would be smallest, right? If cross section area is less, their time taken would be more, because we know that time taken is inversely proportional to the area of cross section, right? So this is about the basic concept of pipes and cisterns. Earlier I expected from you, before watching this session, you may watch my earlier session on time and work, because all types of questions are quite same, right? Only here we have the taps and there we have the persons. So that is end to our session of pipes and cisterns. Hope you enjoyed the session. After watching this session, you may watch my session of practice session on the questions of time, pipes and cisterns. There I explained you how to apply these concepts there. Thank you very much.